Hi guys, come join us on our holiday to Sharm El-Sheik, where we're staying at the Aurora Oriental Hotel.
So this is our room. We have been here for a couple of nights. The first night when we got here, it was super late. So we have been staying here since Thursday. It's now Saturday. At first glance, the room looks fine. Quite big, but that's massive. But when you start to look a little bit closer, it's definitely what you'd describe as tired.
The kettle's nice and clean then.
I don't think anybody uses it. Yeah. It's that hot.
We haven't used it yet. We do have a TV, which
we've also never used.
Yeah, we'll never use this. But this bit, open it up. Show them.
So there is a fridge.
A mini fridge. It doesn't come with anything in it other than water.
Which is good.
But saying that, there is a list on the side here. You can get 3 different mini bar packages. So we got the top one because it's only 450, which is it's about £7. So it's really cheap to fill it up. Little seating area, which we haven't used. An ashtray, so when it is obviously a smoking room.
Obviously.
But it doesn't smell of cigarettes, does it?
No.
That's one thing I haven't noticed.
Everybody seems to smoke over
there. Oh yeah, all the Eastern Europeans.
So this is our balcony.
Actually a really nice view.
But you can see all the way down to the sea.
And it's got a lovely breeze as well.
There's a bit of a walk. We'll head down there shortly and show you it.
They must employ a load of gardeners here because there's always men out tending to the grounds. It's so neat and tidy.
There's so much green, isn't there? Yeah. It's really nice. But let's go back inside. One thing Victoria did notice yesterday while I was in the shower is if you close this door, but you're on the other side of it,
you're locked out.
You can't get back in, there's no handle. So she had to message me, which I didn't get for a while actually. And I came out of the shower and I was like, where is she? And then she was outside laughing to herself. But you get all the standard stuff. The bed is massive, absolutely massive, and it is rock hard.
It's quite a comfy bed actually. The only thing that's really uncomfortable at night is it is so hot because the aircon doesn't work. Yep. It blows out, but you have to literally be stood
just here.
Just in a certain spot, and it's not cold.
No, it's not blowing aircon air out either, it's just blowing air at you.
Yeah, might as well just have a fan in the room. I'd probably do more.
Doesn't matter what you do with this, it just doesn't work. So cold showers before bed, that helps.
So in here, that door's come off its runners a few times while we've been here. There is a safe which you set your own code for, which is quite good. And there's some hanging room, no drawers, so everything's just kind of folded up on the shelves.
There's lots of little bits in there that are just not quite right. Although saying that, for the week, we booked it as a package with EasyJet, so flights, bags, transfers, everything. Wasn't super expensive. We will go over the prices at the end. So you've got to kind of judge it by the price.
Yeah, it was definitely a cheap getaway. So as I say, we have been here a couple of nights, so our stuff is all over the place.
Get a massive mirror.
Yeah. So it's like, I don't know, the sink, there's a bit of a gap there. the back of the door, it's like, I don't know if you can see it on camera, but they've patched the paint up,
yeah,
but not done the whole door, which probably would have taken
down there as well.
Like a couple of minutes more with a roller, just to rip over it.
The shower. And the
shower's actually quite powerful, but you can't have it on full power because the water backs up.
To the buffet in the morning, but this morning we decided we'll have a change. We'll eat on the balcony. We've got room service sent up. It's not expensive. It's a small extra charge. I think two breakfasts, two coffees costs us about £7, so it's absolutely fine. Until 12 o'clock, which was pretty good, but we paid an extra £30, so we'd have to check out till 6 just before we get picked up.
much as it'd be better, really, wouldn't it? Be able to come back here, have a shower and things like that. But from our original, when we turned up and went round the room, I mean, I love watching these types of videos on YouTube. I watch Tim and people go around the room. You get to see it the first time as well as we did and things. But then sometimes I think you kind of forget. Like, we went round the room and yeah, there is little bits that they could do. The room is a little bit tired. I mean, we haven't gone over the price yet. We will, how much we paid. So if you're staying in Dubai and paying thousands of pounds a night, you would expect everything perfect. But here, you kind of forget that there's people are working really hard to make your stay really nice. And sometimes you can forget that looking around, don't you?
Yeah.
So every day we came back, the towels was in a different shape on the bed, which made it a bit more special. And the animation team and Abu and his team was absolutely brilliant, always coming round, really friendly, trying to get you up and dancing and doing yoga and stuff like that. But in a non-pushy way as well, it wasn't too much. It was, they were really lovely and they do a really good job. So would we stay here again?
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, we've already started looking for next year to come back and bring the children, because that's how much of a great time we've had. The beach is absolutely fantastic. The sports on the beach, brilliant. Got prices for scuba diving and things next year. We did go on a couple of trips, went on a sick tour, and we went on a boat trip for snorkeling. They were both amazing.
Yeah, we went on the more budget boat trip, but I can't imagine how it would have been any better. The snorkel guides were absolutely fantastic. Like if we were doing our own thing, jumping off the boat and swimming, probably would have gone the wrong direction and not seen half of the things that we saw that they took us to.
And we did see the more top end, what they call it, the pirate ship, when we came back in, and it was so busy compared to our boat.
Yeah,
it was like, I think we was on the right boat. This ours was just perfect.
Yeah, the food was really nice.
You know, the day couldn't have been any better.
And there again, like they did take some photos, which you didn't have to buy, and it wasn't pushy at all. But I think he was just so nice and funny. And he took some really good shots under the water as well, was that we did end up buying
the
photos and the videos.
I think everybody did.
Yeah.
It was done in a nicer way, you didn't feel robbed.
So I think, looking back, we were probably a little bit negative when we first came to the room. And yeah, the bathroom is a little bit tired and it does need updating, but it's clean.
Yeah, we did also bring up the problem with the aircon.
Oh, yeah.
And that was broken a couple of nights and it was red hot. We went and told the reception, came out and sorted it, and now you have to turn it off after a bit because it gets really cold. It's so powerful. It's really good.
I don't know why we didn't report it after the first night. We were stupid, really. It couldn't have been more helpful.
Yeah, I don't know why we didn't.
There's something else as well that we went to see them about and they sorted it straight away. Oh, the phone.
The phone wasn't working when you tried to order food and things. You could hear them, they couldn't hear you. They came and just brought a new phone in.
Yeah, that was sorted.
And that was sorted straight away.
It was about 15 minutes when we was reporting it. It was done.
Yeah, so the staff couldn't have been... couldn't have done more for you here, could they? So this has been Sharm El-Sheik in October.
We'll definitely come back in October as well, because although it's hot, there's a really, really nice breeze, and we thought that was here all year round.
Yeah.
But the guy from the water sports place said no, it's
he said kitesurfing in October is perfect, because every morning you get this constant breeze.
Yeah.
So we booked the entire trip as a package through EasyJet. This is what we paid, because I can't remember off the top of my head, so it will be above us.
That included flights, transfers, luggage. So it was a really good deal, actually. It's the first time we've been with EasyJet, done a package with them. It's a colleague at work, actually, they told me about it.
Yeah,
couldn't find it cheaper.
You do hear a lot of sometimes bad things about EasyJet,
but
everything's been super smooth.
The company that they work with over here, what's it called?
Travel Co.
They're the ones that come and arrange all your trips and everything. They're brilliant as well. They've teamed up really well there.
Yeah. But yeah, it's been a fantastic time. Everything went smooth, perfect package, holiday.
Yeah, we've fallen in love with Egypt.
Oh, definitely, we'll be back over and over again. The next one, all these different companies and things on Facebook that you see, different travel companies, a lot of them are independent people doing it. One of my friends does it, doesn't she? Well, not one of them, somebody I know from school does it.
One of our colleagues
does it, and they get commission off things you bought, and so many of them, and they always seem to have these amazing deals, so we thought we'll go on one of them and we'll test it out. So the next one was staying for 2 weeks in about February, so the filming obviously will be done in February time. We won't be out till after then. We're going to go enjoy our last day down by the beach.